Welcome back. Let's talk about external service providers. We'll begin with an overview. External service providers, or ESPs, is a designation based on a specific definition in the CMMC program. If an entity is designated as an ESP, that external entity will have CMMC certification requirements. The purpose is to address managed service providers, or MSPs, and managed security service providers, or MSSPs, that support defense contractor systems that are in the CMMC assessment scope. MSPs and MSSPs have very high levels of privileges in systems, and the DoD wants to ensure that these external entities are also operating in a compliant manner. ESPs fall under the Security Protection Asset category and only come into play for CMMC levels 2 and 3. Let's walk through its definition. An ESP can be external people, technology, or facilities. I personally feel that the ESP definition should only include external people or companies because the intent, as I understand it, is to certify external privileged professional services organizations, not to certify technologies or facilities. If you were leveraging external technology or facilities, it would simply fall within your CMMC assessment scope and you would apply the CMMC controls to it. But anyways, let's move on to the next part of the definition. And this part is key, so listen up. The external entity must provision or manage comprehensive IT and/or cybersecurity services on behalf of the organization. What would comprehensive IT services look like? Something like what an MSP would do in managing a contractor's Microsoft 365 environment, creating and managing users, Intune policies, stuff like that. Comprehensive cybersecurity services could be an MSSP providing managed detection and incident response services. CMMC Level 3's Enhanced Security Requirement 3.6.1E requires a 24/7 Security Operations Center capability. If you outsource this to an MSSP, that certainly would fall under comprehensive cybersecurity services. So this is the first test. If true, then move on to the next test. CUI, or security protection data, and the definition says log or configuration data, must be processed, stored, or transmitted on the ESP's assets. If both of these tests are true, then the ESP must be certified at the same level of the defense contractors it supports. Now sure, an MSP or MSSP could encounter CUI data, but let's focus on the security protection data scenario. If an MSP uses their assets to configure your environment, then that would be considered configuration data, which is processed on their assets, which would pass this test. If an MSSP receives log data on their assets from your environment, then that would also pass this test. Some have asked if an MSP could prevent the ESP designation by screen sharing with a client, or perhaps using a client-hosted virtual desktop with appropriate controls to prevent that security protection data from reaching the MSP's assets. This may be possible, but I don't think that would be a scalable approach for MSPs or MSSPs. Now, there is a lot that needs to be clarified here. Security protection data needs further definition. Also, what if we have an entity that would be traditionally considered an external service provider, but they're also FedRAMP moderate authorized? ESPs have been a hot topic during the CMMC rules comment period, and I'm sure DoD is discussing internally, so keep an eye out for further information. Here is the ESP definition from the CMMC program rule. We just broke it down, so I won't go through it again. Just know that this is the source of the ESP definition we just discussed. Further down in section 170.19 of the CMMC program rule, it says that ESPs, other than CSPs, must have a CMMC level 2 certification assessment. What I believe they're trying to do here is differentiate between cloud service providers, which already have FedRAMP moderate equivalency requirements from DFAR 7012. that's not the only confusing part. When it says if the ESP is internal to the OSA, I think they are referring to a scenario where a MSP is actually the one being certified and they use their internal MSP capabilities to support their CMMC assessment scope. The rest of the text is easier to understand, so we'll leave it there. This section basically says the same thing, but for CMMC level 3. All right. Let's summarize. External Service Providers, or ESPs, is a designation based on a specific definition in the CMMC program. If an entity is designated as an ESP, that external entity will have CMMC certification requirements. The purpose is to address MSPs and MSSPs that support in-scope defense contractor systems. An ESP can be external people, technology, or facilities. The ESP designation has two primary tests. The first test is evaluating if the external entity provides or manages comprehensive IT and/or cybersecurity services on the defense contractor's behalf. If so, the second test is this. Is CUI or security protection data processed, stored, or transmitted on the ESP's assets? If both of these tests are true, then the ESP must be certified at the same level of the defense contractors it supports. All right, that's all for this one. See you in the next one.